Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can convert your TensorFlow model into a TA flight model and use it. So let's begin.
So this is our TensorFlow model. So here you can see the extension is a dot model, but in your case it can be .ld5 or .h5. So this method would still work for you. So let me first walk you through the code, and so that you'll come to know how this model works, and then we'll see how to convert it. So here I've imported a few things. Here I've read the model, here I've read the labels, and then I'll read the image, and then I'll finally pass it to the model, and then it will predict which activity is being performed by doing some image classification. This is the image that it would be trying to predict. So let's run it. So here you can see it has predicted that the action is push up, which is correct. So now what we want to do is we want to convert this TensorFlow or Keras model into a TensorFlow Lite model and then use it. So let's see how to do it. So the first thing that we need to do is we'll import TensorFlow. So note that the TensorFlow version that I'm using is TensorFlow 2.4.1. So if your TensorFlow is like very old or very different from this version, then it might not work, so you need to check that. So then we'll import load model. Then we'll read our model. So my model is located at in this folder. tf.lite.tflightconverter.from Keras model. So this is the method or function that we'll be using. Then we'll write tf light model is equal to converter dot convert. Then we'll finally write the TensorFlow Lite model file into our system. We'll name that file as activity lite.tflite. So the extension should be .tflite. We'll be writing it in binary format. Now we'll run our program. So now that when I run it, So let's see if whether a file has been created or not. So here you can see a file has been created successfully. Next we'll see how to use this TensorFlow model file, just like the way we used our normal TensorFlow model file. So now we'll see how to write a program for using a TensorFlow Lite model for inferencing. So here I've imported a few modules, and here the mean is the ImageNet RGB mean, which will be subtracting later from our image once we read it. Now here we'll be creating our interpreter. So interpreter is equals to tf.light.interpreter model path equals to name of our model. Now we'll be allocating tensors. Now this helps us to get input and output details. So now we'll write input details is equals to interpreter dot get input details. Similarly, output details interpreter dot get output details. Now we'll just print the input details and see what values are there in it. So you can see it contains additionally, okay, which has different types of keys like index, which has a value 0. We'll be using this. Okay, and there are many other details like the shape of the input array that it expects. Like for example, here it expects an image of size 24 by 24 of RGB type. Okay, and it accepts single image at a time, and other information as well. You can see. Similarly, we have output details as well, which contains other kinds of information, specifically output details. Okay. So now we'll read the labels. So labels is equal to pickle dot loads open activity labels dot pickle comma read binary dot read image equals to save it to dot imread. p024.jpg and then we'll convert it to an RGB image since OpenCV reads images in BGR format. We'll be using cv2color method. we'll resize the image. cv2.resize image 224 by 224. Dot AS type float 32. Then we'll subtract the main from the image. Now we will set the input tensor. So we'll write interpreter dot set tensor. So here the first argument is a tensor index, which will be the index of the input index that we'll get from the input details. And here the second argument will be our input image. So here we'll write input details 0 index. Since it was a dictionary inside a list, so hence we'll write 0 to access the entire dictionary, and then to get the index value from the dictionary, we have entered the key so that we'll get its corresponding value. Here we'll write np dot expand dims image access equals to 0. So here we have entered our image and uses expand dims to add an extra dimension. Since it enters input in the form of 1, 2, 24, 2, 24, 3, which we had seen earlier. Now once we set our input tensor, we will invoke our inference. We will invoke our interpreter. So we'll write interpreter dot invoke . Now we'll get a prediction. So pred is equals to interpreter dot get tensor output details 0 comma index. And then we'll get the highest index value of our prediction. So we'll use np.argmax to get the index location of highest prediction value. Label equals to labels dot . Then we'll print our output or label. So let's see. So you can see our model has predicted the action from our input image. I hope you found this video helpful. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much.